Legislator is a program that avails you to know more about your legislators, their constituency projects, and some other legislative activities. A world that anchoring this program, Christy Ewudage is my name. I will not be doing this alone. I have here with me a co-anchor. I am talking of Mama Mohammed. Well, I have here with me a special guest, Senator Abdullahi Ibrahim. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
He has his first degree on Hon-High Institute of Nigeria Technology, United States of America. He holds a master's degree in electrical engineering from the University of Detroit in the United States and a doctoral degree in electrical engineering in energy from Abubakar Tafawa Balewa University in Bauchi, Nigeria. He is a chartered engineer and a fellow of the Institute of Electrical Engineers, United Kingdom, and of the Nigerian Society of Engineers. He also has his MBA in the University of Liverpool. Senator Gobet began his career with the Ministry of Communication and then joined the Nigerian Television Authority in Sokoto. He was director of about 10 companies, including Union Bank of Nigeria. He contested for a seat in the Sokoto East Senatorial District and won. Distinguished, you're welcome to the program.
Thank you very much.
Distinguished, we want you to assess so far the direction that the Ninth Senate is heading, going by the roadmap set during the inauguration of the Ninth Senate. Do you think you are on the right path to accomplishing all that was said during the inauguration?
Well, thank you very much for this very important question. If you look at exactly what happened on the 9th of June 2019, by the time we were inaugurated, what we have been following is actually the roadmap that we have set ourselves. That's the legislative agenda of the 9th Senate. And I think, honestly, if you look at it carefully, so far, so good, because we have been doing very, very well. What we have taken to be of uttermost importance is to make sure that, one, the issue of budgeting system has been effected. And I think we have done that. If you look at it now, we used to have our budget around around June. But today, as we are talking, we started the budget in January. That means we finished it in December and then passed it in that December and then sent it to the executive and it has been approved. But of course, I'm not sure whether the implementation has been done or has even started. But we have done our own, you know, that we have passed the budget and it has been assented to in January. What we are not sure is about the implementation of it will be done. But we pray that the implementation will start immediately.
All right, so speaking on the budget, I am glad to congratulate you, first of all, because this is the first time in your long time that the budget was passed timely and accurately. I want to ask, even though you just said you're not sure if the implementation has started, but how well do you think the senators have prepared themselves when it comes to oversight that is needed to keep everybody in check?
Yeah, I think this is one area, because it's part of the areas that we said we would have to do. Oversight functions, I think, are the most important functions, apart from legislation, of the National Assembly. And because of that, we put a lot of importance to that. And many of us are moving everywhere within our own jurisdiction to make sure that oversight function is actually effective. And then to make sure that things have been done. But I am thinking that as of now, that implementation of that budget has not been done. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I will continue to press for that to be implemented.
You are the chairman of the Senate Committee on Security. Concerning the security situation in Nigeria today, one cannot to ask you some questions that has to do with security. Having played host of the Inspector General of Police a few weeks ago, what are the far-reaching assurances Nigerians will be getting and in terms of getting to see better tomorrow?
Well, like you said, honestly, the issue of security in this country is something that affects everybody. In fact, particularly the members of the National Assembly, the Senate and the House. We have been looking at that issue, trying to see how we can find solution to the problem of insecurity in this country. And we are actually working very hard to see that the security issue will be a thing of the past, by the grace of God. Because many of us are actually serious about this. And we believe that the best way to tackle it is to find the root cause of this problem. And I think this is a great way. When we had the meeting with the Inspector General of Police, we were given a lot of assurances. We discussed. And these are things that I cannot give out to the public because of the security issues now. But I assure you that the IGP is ready to move ahead to make sure that all these problems are sorted out. Nigerians will be happy and then they will be protected because the internal security is, of course, the primary objective of the police force.
I quite know that you wouldn't want to, you know, talk more on security, but I thought that since you are the chairman, you should be able to give us assurance, and you just did that you had a very robust discussion with the Inspector General of Police and has assured Nigerians of a better tomorrow.
A committee was set up to review the 1999 Constitution of Nigeria by the Senate President on 6th of February. I just wanted to know, the move was applauded by a lot of Nigerians who were happy that finally something is going to be done in this direction. But however, there were sections of the Constitution that were highlighted to be reviewed and not all. I wanted to ask, do you think that these sections that were chosen are the most pressing issues we have, or like what criteria was used to select the sections that were chosen?
Yeah, but let me tell you one thing. Constitutional review does not necessarily mean whatever is mentioned there is the only thing that should be reviewed. In fact, any Nigerian can propose something to say that he believes or a community or a group or a committee or association can actually come up and then ask for a review of certain areas or certain sections of the Constitution. Then, in that case, now the committee will look at those areas and then try to do justice to the areas. If it is actually necessary to review that portion of the Constitution, I assure you it will be reviewed and then it will go so that we can see whether it will pass the test of litmus, because we will have to debate it, we will have to vote it, and then if we take the vote and it passes the vote, then of course we will go ahead and do it. Then you know, correcting or altering the Constitution will require two-thirds of the 36 states in the Constitution. So which means that at least 24 states out of the 36 must approve it before it can be adopted. Right, then so the president will accept it.
Because, I mean, we talk about it so much, about how we want things to be different, but do you think that if constitutionally, maybe because one of the sections to be changed is petroleum, if a change is affected in the petroleum section of the Constitution, do you think that Nigerians are ready to accept? How willing do you think we'll be to accept these changes?
Those changes in petroleum, because
the parts of this Constitution that were slated to be to start review, petroleum is one of them. I'm just using as an example.
Yeah, okay, but all I know is that in the petroleum we have the DID bill, and yes, DID bill will come up, and then we'll debate it, and then we'll go ahead and do it. Some part of it may not necessarily be part of the constitutional fresh, you know, but whatever the situation is, by the time we finish that one, it will be taken to Nigerians, it will be taken to the states, and the states will vote for it. If it passes the test, then it will be sent to the president of the Federal Republic of Nigeria for assessment.
Sometimes a question radically comes to one's mind to ask, what about if there is a sense of review, overhauling of the whole constitution? Is it possible?
Yeah, but I think with time, gradually, we'll be able to do that. But to say that you will have to change the entire constitution, I think that would require a memorandum, an referendum.
Several questions have been raised on the issue of our electoral acts. Coupled with the recent Supreme Court judgment on the gubernatorial elections in Bayelsa and some other states, would you therefore succumb to the agitation for a total overhauling of our electoral acts?
No, but I think we have done that. If you look at it, we just passed the Amendment Act. Then now there will be another amendment with an amendment. And this is dynamic. And we continue to amend until we get the total perfection of what the electoral act is. And you cannot say that whatever you do is totally bad or totally wrong. You will continue to to overhaul it. You continue to amend it until you reach perfection. But nothing can be done so perfectly. Look at what is happening now today in the United States. You have seen what is going on. You have seen how Trump is also changing the whole situation. And you see how Americans are agitating. It is not only Nigeria. You see, it's the same problem all over. The same problem.
Considering that most bills passed by the 8th Assembly was rejected by the President, what certainty do you have that most of the bills that will be passed by the 9th Assembly or Assembly will be endorsed by the President?
No, I believe they will be endorsed because what we have done or what we are going to do this time is that we have a last song. And the fundamental issue is that any bill that is passed, then there is actually a go-between the National Assembly and the presidency. And in that case, they will look at that area. It will be perfected. And then perfected again until we get it right. And then later we send it to you and assent it. And if you look at it, even the other time, we had this problem where a lot of bills were returned, where the president declined to assent. I think it was perfected. I sent it back to him and then he assented it. You see, we have to look at that. It takes two to tango. The two of us are working for the common good of Nigerians. And therefore, if there is a small mistake from either the presidency or the National Assembly, the correction will be done. And once this corrected, it is sent. And if there is anything he sends to us and tells us this is what we did, which is wrong, we also look at it also. You know, the legal team of the National Assembly will look at it. And then where corrections should be done, it will be corrected. And then taken back to us.
Distinguished, some section of the public are of this opinion that this bills in this night's Senate is being passed like hook and sinker. Is that true?
No, it's not true. You know, we look at everything the way they should be looked at. And you can look at the quality of people we have in the Ninth Assembly. And the people are doing what they are supposed to. Nobody is allowing everything to pass under the carpet. We get it out. We go through it. You know, then after doing that, it has to pass the litmus test. And then later, we actually pass it. We are not just passing this like that, we're passing it. You are there. You are also part and parcel of us. So you educate Nigerians on what we do. We are doing the right thing. Nobody is actually insisting that his bill, whether it's good or not, should be passed. You know that one. Because you're part of us.
Well, it's been a very wonderful time and, of course, very educating and purposeful having this beautiful discussion with Senator Kubri. Well, thanks for having you here.
Thank you
for doing justice to our questions.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you so much. It's on this note we want to specially thank you for being part and listening and watching. We do hope you join us next time. Until we come your way again, God bless Nigeria.